Rosenstern Computer Internet Show.
Y'all, it's the world premiere of the play The Fabulous Lipitones at the Theatrical Outfit. Co-writers John Markus and Mark St. Germain have more TV and playwriting awards between them than I can count on one hand, and I got to talk to them both today.
Hello and welcome to the Gilda Sue Rosenstern Computer Internet Show. I am Gilda Sue Rosenstern. I'm tickled pink to be here. I'm back at the beautiful Theatrical Outfit in Atlanta, Georgia, with my illustrious guest, John Markus. John Markus, thank you for joining me.
Hello, Gilda Sue. It's nice to meet you.
Oh, it's lovely to meet you. I have been looking forward to it. I've been Googling you. He's my most Googleable guest so far.
And you know, when I'm Googled, I actually feel it.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm a little embarrassed then about how many times I did it. Now, I will say this. We always celebrate here on the Gilda Sue Rosenstern Computer Internet Show with a beverage. It's a little early for Drambuie, so I thought we'd start with mimosas.
There goes my work day, but I couldn't think of a better reason to sit and enjoy this with you.
Yeah, I think it's appropriate to have mimosas on a good Friday. Oh, alrighty. So thanks for joining me. And when I say mimosas, I don't mean to imply that there's orange juice involved.
This is almost like a date in a way. Wouldn't you say that?
It is kind of like a date.
I know, with cameras.
Date with cameras is my favorite kind.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm getting used to it, but I could go with it.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, well, good. Let's just see. Let's go with the flow. All right, so
it's great to meet somebody like, as well as everyone else I get to meet over the internet.
Yeah.
Because I did Google you, too. I've been a fan of yours for about 6 months.
6 whole months?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm just tickled pink to hear that. I love it. So you've watched the computer internet show.
I have. I've looked at most episodes. Because I find that once you start, you can't stop.
Okay. Oh, well, that's sweet.
Yeah.
I have that effect on people.
Yeah, you do it to me.
Okay, so let me ask you. You are here at the Theatrical Outfit because you have written a play. You've co-written a play. Tell us about this play.
This play is set in the world of barbershop harmony.
And,
four people singing very close harmony together, usually really old traditional songs. Well, there's a surprise in the play as to this quartet loses their fourth member during a competition.
And when you say fourth member, you mean a whole person?
I'm talking about the person.
Okay.
You went somewhere else with that?
I just want to be clear. I want to make sure everybody knows what's up.
Sure.
Yeah. Okay, so this play opens here at the Theatrical Outfit. What's the date of its opening?
We are opening, the opening date is March 30th, a Saturday, which probably has passed by the time people get to see this. I don't know how.
2013.
And it's going to run for, I think, approximately 4 weeks here, 3 weeks or so. And there's a chance if people are enjoying it and coming, they're going to extend it.
Extend it.
So I'd say come early so that then it can last longer.
Yeah. Is that how it works?
That's just how I put it.
Okay, excellent. We always want to know how it works. So where does your play go after it leaves the South? Does it go up to Yankee Town somewhere? And do you even know?
Yankee Town is interested in
it. Yeah, yeah.
And the play will open in Connecticut on May the 9th at the Goodspeed Theater. Which is near New Haven.
Okay, so you've co-written this play in truth, right?
There's another writer involved.
And
I co-wrote it with him. I don't know where he is today, but he wasn't able to make it.
Who wrote more words, you or him?
We haven't done a word count.
Well, I find that hard to believe. You didn't keep track.
We get paid the same.
You don't get paid by the word.
No, we don't get paid by the word. Because then I would have written a whole, it would have been 4 hours long.
Right, right. Wait, what's this gentleman's name?
His name is Mark St. Germain.
John?
What?
John?
Oh, hey, Mark. This is my co-writer.
Please have a seat.
The cameras? What's?
Well sit
there
down.
Was an, I tried to get you. I don't know, did you get my voicemail?
No.
Oh, well, I left you one. I scheduled an interview with...
That's
really strange, because usually we hear about the interviews together.
Hmm.
You're so busy. You have so many things you're working on. He's a very busy player.
Really, nothing. I was sitting back.
You don't
back
look
at the
all
hotel
that busy.
Room.
In fact, look.
Oh, well, there
thank
you go.
You.
I think that we can smooth all this over.
Really?
I appreciate it.
I mean, it's like, you know, I don't know. I certainly...
Thank you.
Well, you're welcome, and cheers.
Cheers.
I'm just tickled pink, and now I have two playwrights on my show. So I was trying to find out who wrote more words in this play, you or Mr. Markus?
Well, you know, before...
Thank you for clearing that up. I love a decisive answer.
Okay. I did a word count?
Yeah.
That
probably
makes...
1,000 more.
1,000 more. Let me ask you this. Mr. Saint Germain, what are you the saint of?
It really depends on the country.
Okay. In this
here
country...
Here it's small animals.
You are the saint of small animals?
I've seen it. We can tell you how the Fabulous Lipitones came into being.
Let's hear it.
The play that's opening here at Theatrical
Outfit. Right. Let's hear how did y'all get together and make this play?
Mark and I worked together first 20 years ago on the Cosby Show.
The Bill Cosby Show?
Well, that one was called the Cosby Show. They dropped the Bill.
It was implied.
Yeah. And I worked on that show, and we brought Mark in to work on the show, so we got to know each other then.
He was there first?
Are you really telling her this story? Are you trying to impress her?
It's on my resume. It's, you know,
but John,
I was the showrunner for 6 years.
John tells people that, and it's true. It turns up on the screen, but actually he was Mr. Cosby's driver, and he had nothing to do during the day, so he sat in the writer's room.
Well, here's what I would think about being.
I gave him a lot of good ideas on the ride in.
Right.
And he took them.
Let me ask you this: y'all are Yankees, is this right?
That's right.
But here's the little kind of twist with me. I'm a Yankee who knows how to barbecue. Mm-hmm.
Yes, you know, I did when I Googled you. One thing I learned is you're sort of a meat geek.
Well, I believe that the only way to cook the barbecue properly is you got to learn to sleep with your meat.
I believe that my mama told me that.
Okay.
I really think I should leave.
Oh, please.
Well,
please,
Mark, if you you're writing now, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. You're right. This has been a great pleasure.
I am so tickled you stopped by. Thank you so much, Mark St. Germain.
Could I take this with me?
Go right ahead.
Mark, I'm so glad that you found...
Yeah, sure, John.
Bye!
He's a good actor as well as a writer. He actually can act very well, and he, you know...
This is interesting. I wish he hadn't gone, because do you know this about me? I'm making a movie about my life.
No kidding.
Yeah, but I'm thinking, would you like to be in it?
What part would you see me playing?
Well, the part of my rib Spiderman, is open.
Well, it almost feels like I'm torn, because it feels like a little typecasting to make the Jewish guy a rabbi. I haven't been one, but I've seen them.
So you believe what? You believe that it would be more interesting if I cast like Chris Rock as my rabbi?
I do think that's really interesting casting. And
is he available?
I can ask.
Ask Bill Cosby. I'm sure he knows.
I tell people that I'm as famous as you can be without being famous.
Exactly.
That is exactly how
I feel.
Yeah.
And then when you are in the movie about my life playing Rabbi Spiderman, we're both going to be so famous.
Oh, that's really exciting. I think I'll do this. If I pass the audition, I'd like to be in your film.
Excellent. You heard it here first, y'all. John Markus, TV producer / writer extraordinaire, playwright, co-playwright, is going to be in my movie. He's going to play Rabbi Spiderman.
I'm very directable.
Did you put that on your computer internet dating site as well?
No, that's not on there yet either. Hmm. I think that it would be a great pleasure to spend a little more time with you, Gilda.
Well, we're going to make that happen, aren't we, John Markus?
Let's see what Mom and Dad say.
All right.
Here's
cheers.
To them.
Y'all, thanks so much for joining us. I'm just tickled pink. And don't forget to go out and see the Fabulous Lipitones here at the beautiful Theatrical Outfit in Atlanta, Georgia.
Do you like French food?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bye, Neil.
Y'all, I went to the opening night of the world premiere of the Fabulous Lipitones, and it rocked. The cast is full of cute men, and they all sing. I give it 13 canishes.
I would like to be abducted by a UFO. I think about that sometimes.
Oh, this is interesting.
Really? And I always look up at the heavens and say, come and get me.
And they don't do it.
No, and then I even add, anal probes are okay.
Buff, buff.